The year that was 2015 for property markets and urban agenda. Well, we started a new segment, Citizens Voice, to bring you inspiring stories of common citizens who actually have made a big impact in the way they live. This is the story of Gurgaon. Citizens who fought against all odds to reclaim the green lungs of their city. With help from corporates, a group of residents under the banner I'm Gurgaon transformed a mining site into a biodiversity park that is a pride of Gurgaon today.
We are at the biodiversity park in Gurgaon. Till 2009, this was a mining site. The lush green that you see behind us came up just in the past 4 to 5 years, and all because of the effort of the citizens I have here with me. So, how difficult has it been for you all, your team, the citizens here, to hold on to the park?
So it was not that simple to start work here, but it is getting more and more difficult to hold on to this place. I think it's about everybody has a view.
Yeah.
Everybody has a view about what they want to do this place. Somebody wants to start ecotourism here. They want to do night safari, Yurong Bird Park. I think what we are creating is a native Aravali forest. And we have that vision in mind. MCG agrees with that vision.
Yes.
And we should just go with it.
Over to you. Tell us more about the presence here.
So this park over the last 2-3 years has emerged as one of the most important birding habitats in the NCR region. Mm-hmm. There are certain species of birds like Sarkir Malkoha, and then you would have Indian rock owl. You would hardly see them anywhere else in NCR. Their numbers have gone down in other places because of habitat destruction and other reasons. But we come here and we see those birds abundantly here.
One section of the government still wants you all to continue maintaining this particular park. So while another faction wants to take over, they are even planning to go to the chief minister. So how do you plan? What's your action plan next?
I am surprised is that we get visit from Environment Minister who comes here, who looks at the place. He pats on our back saying that incredible work. I guess our strategy, I mean, we haven't heard from MCG. MCG has always been supportive of the work we have been doing. They're appreciative. We don't know how it is going to pan out, but we'll definitely work with MCG to create this into some kind of a conservation reserve.
Saguji, would like to come to you. You've been, you're here every morning for your morning walks. So how has it been?
For me, it's a tremendous boon. I've been walking here for the last 23 years. And when I used to come in the beginning, I had to come with a big stick so that I could move the weeds, watch out for snakes. And so my entire focus was on the environment rather than on the walk.
Yeah.
Now with this thing, I walk here. It's my best part of my day. I spend 45 minutes walking in different parts and thinking, visualizing, dreaming.
I can still see you sweating from your morning walk. So your experiences in this park?
Well, I have been coming here for the last 4 years now. And it is a wonderful experience. In fact, I am maybe not knowing anybody who's involved in creation of this.
Yeah.
But I am a promoter and advertise so much for this park. Right. Anybody comes and asks me that how come you can work 16 hours a day? And I only say secret is get morning
walks
in biodiversity park.
I guess it's it's in the end it's always the citizen power that prevails.
Yeah.
And BDP is an example of active citizenship to prevail in spite of challenges.
Yes.
To work towards ownership with a sense of ownership for the city and a sense of motivation. And I'm sure the team here can ward off any such challenge that comes in the future.
Thank you all so much for joining me here today morning. So you have the citizens who have done their bit to maintain this green space. Maybe it's high time for the government to do their bit and support such successful public-private partnerships.
Painting is a powerful expression of one's belief. And in Mumbai, a group of women who call themselves Rasta Chhap are using this medium of paint and brush to save Mumbai's receding greens. How? By painting the stumps of the dead drain greens.
Walk across Jehu these days and you're likely to come across many trees such as this one, brilliantly coloured and painted. But it's not just an art project. It's actually a movement called Rasta Chhap, which aims to spread awareness about the need to save trees and prevent excessive concretization.
it raises a lot of awareness. Like when we painted this, there were tons of people that came up and asked us and helped us out.
I thought that it's our responsibility as a future generation to give back to nature in any way possible.
To begin with, Rasta Chup, how did this movement or this organization come about?
It's basically art with a purpose. We realized that somewhere art always has a way of telling a story and tugs at people's hearts. And that's how we formed Rasta Chup. We called it that because we wanted a very colloquial, ethnic-looking name, a name that which everyone can relate to, whether it is the young or the old.
If you're walking past a dead tree, you would not notice it until it is painted, and you'll see, why is this thing painted, you know, a tree right in the middle of a road painted. So when you see it painted is when you'll realize it is dead. That's why it is painted. So to just people should notice how many trees are dead, and so that's why we are painting them. And so we have to do something about them to stop them from dying.
You have to get the canvas ready. So we first sandpaper it in order to give it a smooth palette, and then we primer it. So primering is giving it a base. So you give it like a white base, so the artist that comes can play around with their vision, play with colors, and work on it in any beautification way that they want.
Why these trees are dying is because they are becoming weak. They're becoming weak because there is no space to breathe. Now the BMC contractor, when the road guy goes to get a road contract, he is paid separately for embankments. A tree that has no road, so I'm sure he must be giving a large list of trees to get a higher budget to make his road. So when he's got that higher budget, when he's getting paid separately the embankment, why isn't the embankment not being done? You know, our whole effort right now is actually get the attention of the MC and to municipal commissioner and to tell him, now this is something which he has to take on at a war footing. Second thing is, can we as citizens go out there and file FIRs against whom we tell us? I mean, the BMC, the road contractor, because somebody has to be told that this cannot go on.
Going ahead, how do you expect to expand this movement? How do you expect to draw more attention to your cause?
Actually, the painting of the trees has really drawn a lot of attention to us. I've been getting phone calls continuously for people who want to do work, but they don't know how to go about it. So what we really want is now, if people who've called us, somebody called me and said, Hasnabagh Lane in Santa Cruz is really bad, and can you help us with that? So I spoke to him, I said, I'll meet you. I would like you to form a group of your own. Yeah, and under Rasta Chup, we will guide you through the process, we'll get you the permissions, we'll tell you how to go about it. I think the BMCs are very helpful, but they need some support from us. And as citizens, we need to take cognizance of at least our area.
Going ahead, do you think your movement will inspire more action being taken on the cause?
We have 40 volunteers today who are ready to paint for us, who are ready to, you know, probably do recce's for us, who are ready to tell us what is the state of the trees on their road. And eventually we think that even if one or two people come forward to adopt a tree just in their lane, just opposite their homes, that's all it takes.
If there are more people out there who are watching this right now and they want to basically get in touch, maybe not to form their own group, maybe to even join your group, or even to just get suggestions, what's your advice to them in terms of contacting you?
They can contact us on our Facebook page, Rasta Chup, and write us comments on our Facebook page so we can get back to them.
From Mumbai, Nikhil Narayan Shivdas, NDTV.
Impossible to possible, that's what each of these citizen voice examples reminds us of. So let's ring in 2016 with new hope and good wishes for good deals, or rather great deals in real estate. Happy New Year from the entire Property Show team of the NDTV Network. Goodbye.